Hello folks. So do you wonder on how to train deep learning neural networks on GPU based machine, without spending a single penny on cloud platform? So if you know, just to let you know about it, generally we train the deep learning neural network on a GPU based machine or TPU based machine instead of CPU based machines. Okay. So in this video, I'm going to introduce Google Colaboratory for running the TensorFlow code. Okay, this is a free service provided by Google to train your neural networks using GPU or TPU based machines in a matter of minutes. Okay, so Colaboratory is a hosted Jupyter notebook environment that is free to use and require almost no setup. So keep watching this video till the end to see how to use these GPU based machines on Jupyter notebooks on Google Colaboratory for training your deep learning neural networks. Folks, this is Nitin, who is on a mission to democratize artificial intelligence, big data, Hadoop, cloud computing, and blockchain to the entire world. And with this aim, I'm regularly creating the associated content and publishing it as well on the periodic basis in order to make it available to the entire community who wants to learn these modern technologies. And you can subscribe to my channel or press the bell icon to keep on getting the latest updates regarding hottest technologies of 21st century. You can also follow me on Twitter and Facebook at the link given above. And I have also added subtitles in the languages like Hindi, English, and French for your convenience. So you can enable them as per your needs. So the purpose of Google Colaboratory is to train your deep neural network in a matter of minutes, because if you train these deep learning neural networks on CPU, okay, machines, then it would take hours or even sometimes days to train a single deep learning neural network. Okay, and if the data set is, let us say, terabyte scale, then it would definitely take days to train deep learning neural network on CPU machines. So in order to avoid shortcomings of CPU machines or the traditional central processing unit, okay, which we call as CPU, we use graphical processing units called GPU. So these are in fact more advanced than CPU machines, and using these GPU machines we can basically perform the operations in parallel. So kind of, a distributed environment where we can do some parallel processing as well. Okay, apart from having a, some more advanced memory the space. So generally the memory size is very huge in case of GPU machines. So that's the whole reason, it generally caches. So let us say we have gigabytes or terabytes of data, then the GPU machines can cache that data in the memory of GPU machines. So these memory scale somewhere between 240 GB to 480 GB and so on. Okay, so that is a huge size of memory we require for GPU machines in order to cache the data in the memory size. But if you use CPU machines, won't actually cache the huge data in the memory, and it will take a lot of time, or either sometimes it will go down. Okay, it even won't process such a huge amount of data, the terabytes or petabytes of data. So that is the whole reason we use GPU machine. And you can use any cloud platform like Google Cloud, Microsoft Azure, or AWS to spin up GPU machines and then train your model. Definitely, these cloud platforms charge on hourly basis for using their infrastructure. Okay, but if you don't want to spend your money and is looking for some free solution, then you can use Google Colaboratory to train your deep learning neural networks free of cost. Okay, just total free of cost. And Google has done this tremendous job in providing this free capability to data science community. So we should be very grateful to them. And I have created a 2-video series on Google Colaboratory so you can actually watch those videos on how to spin up the GPU machines using Google Colaboratory. And here's the playlist link. Okay. So here is the playlist link. You can basically watch those two videos. Okay, so it is opening up and you can see here the deep learning neural network tutorials. So there are two videos associated with these Google Collaboratory information. So you can get entire details in this particular video series. You will be able to know how to mount your drive, how to basically run bash commands on Google Collaboratory, etc. Okay, so let's move on. So let's create a new notebook on you know, Google Collaboratory. So I have already opened this Google Collaboratory. You can basically use this link, which is colab.research.google.com, and you will be able to. And obviously, you need to have a Gmail ID in order to utilize this service. Okay, because it will ask for credentials to log in. Right, so you can see this is the collaboratory environment. Okay, and let's create a new notebook. So here you are given options like new Python 2 notebook or Python 3. Let's click on Python 3 notebook. Okay, so when you create a new notebook on Google Colab, TensorFlow is already pre-installed and optimized for hardware being used. Okay, so let me show you the runtime environment. So you can change the runtime environment from runtime, and then let me tell you once again. So runtime, click on runtime and then change runtime environment. So you can see the hardware accelerator right now, it is none or default CPU. You can change it to GPU or TPU. Okay, so let me make it as GPU and save. So now the hardware acceleration set as GPU. Okay, so whatever the deep learning neural networks you will build, you will definitely you know, utilize this advanced technique of GPU based accelerators. Okay, so what I was telling, so TensorFlow is already pre-installed and optimized for the hardware being used. So just import TensorFlow as TF and you can start coding. So if you type import TensorFlow as TF and press shift enter, you can right away, you know, start coding using the TensorFlow environment because it is by default pre-installed here. Okay, and since TensorFlow is a Google product and runs on Google Cloud platform, so GCP or Google Cloud platform is gradually pacing up to capture the cloud computing market. Okay, and you can say that TensorFlow is a differentiating factor when it comes to you know, choosing machine learning platforms on Google Cloud platform. Microsoft Azure provides Azure Machine Learning Studio, and AWS or Amazon Web Services provide SageMaker to quickly build, train and deploy machine learning models at the scale. But since TensorFlow is a tool of choice for building neural networks, so GCP has an edge on its competitors, as GCP offers TensorFlow natively, as you can see here. You know, you just typed this command and it has very well taken it. Otherwise, if you use other platforms, then you need to install the TensorFlow library in those cloud platform. Okay, so folks, this is it for this video. To conclude, I gave a short introduction of Google Collaboratory, told you about why GPU or TPU based machines are preferred over TPU based machines when it comes to trained deep neural network, and also showcased you like how you know, the TensorFlow is an inbuilt feature of Google Collaboratory or Google Cloud platform, right? You don't need to externally download, in fact install TensorFlow libraries, right? So you can right away start writing code from here. I will be covering the you know, the code related topics in the upcoming videos, but for this video it was just a short introduction. So folks, please post your comments and let me know if you have any specific topics in mind which you want me to cover as a part of this TensorFlow series, as some of your some of the best tips and the feedback comes from you only. So I would like to hear more from you. And if you're watching this video and you are not already a subscriber to our channel, consider clicking that little subscribe button. And in case you have already subscribed, then click on bell icon to receive the notifications whenever I will release a new video. So thanks for hanging out with me, guys. I will be covering next topics in the upcoming videos. So keep on watching. Thank you.